This week's announcement of US troop withdrawals from Afghanistan will be cold comfort to a small group of civilians in northeast England. They're part-time soldiers enlisted with the Territorial Army. And with Britain's regular troops overstretched, they're on standby to be thrown into the front lines. Dateline's Evan Williams joined their unit as they got the call to war.
It's a cold dawn, and a company of young British soldiers is under attack. This is just a training exercise, and it's happening in the safety of northern England. But soon, these soldiers will be in Afghanistan, in what many say will be the fiercest fighting season so far. The soldiers are members of the reserve force known as the Territorial Army, or the TA. They are plumbers, students, bakers, volunteers drawn from everyday life and paid to do part-time military training.
It's called bombing because the bombs up in the air.
Former Navy officer Chris Hall helps run one of the TA companies.
Once you start the training, you can be, while you're training for Afghanistan, being delivering letters or repairing toilets. And then at the weekends training to go to war, and going back and delivering letters again, etc. Until eventually the TA hand those soldiers over to the regulars. They go to war, quite literally, and then when they return, after their time off, they go back to delivering letters and repairing toilets again.
Originally I joined the TA because I was on a college course, I was on a bit of a minuscule grant, and it was to get extra money basically. I saw an advert in the local paper which had three guys jumping out of Westland, Wessex, carrying SLRs. And I thought it looked quite exciting. I got to carry an SLR, but it was some years later before I got to jump out of Westland, Wessex. You get a monthly wage based on how many MTDs, man training days, that you've completed during the month. Friendship as well, you know, you meet people who you stay mates with for, you know, for years.
Today, the 5th Fusiliers are getting ready to mark St George's Day, the patron saint of England and of the unit itself. It might look a little quaint, but there's a deadly serious side.
Well, the image of the TA 10 years ago was that the regulars thought they were just a drinking club. They were just a group of people that put combats on and had socials. But things have changed dramatically since Iraq, well, since Bosnia, the start of Bosnia, then Kosovo, Iraq, Afghanistan. The TA have been on a constant war tempo ever since. It has changed dramatically to a very switched on operational fighting force.
By the left, quick march, left, right, left, right, left, right, left.
In theory, the Territorial Army is a separate army to provide numbers. It was raised with the idea, as in the First World War.
Professor Michael Clark studies the demands on Britain's armed forces and says the TA plays a critically important role.
These people have been deployed in ones and twos in order to make up shortages. That was the case in the medical services some time ago. And those ones and twos have now become about 30% of our full force deployment across any given operation.
49, 50, 51, 52,
53, 54.
TA members get about $50 for each day they turn up for training and more for fighting overseas. In the depressed northeast, that can make all the difference to a struggling family like new father Darren Longstaff.
It's a money salary. It's about £27,000 for me.
That's what you came out with, £27,000 from the deployment.
That's not including the £5,500, but it's a lot of money.
Yeah.
So I think everyone's in the same boat here. It's a financial incentive. Well, I've got a little daughter, actually. She's called Holly.
Holly?
Yeah. Don't want to leave her, like, but you want to look at the career side of things, haven't you, really? And we move forward in life.
Yeah.
But Darren knows that earning that money carries risk, and that soon he'll be in a real-life war zone.
What the TA used to do is that they used to backfill, so that they used to take supporting roles to release regulars to go to the front, as it were, to take on the combat roles. And that was fine, but increasingly what's needed is not infantry or frontline troops. What's needed are the specialists, and the specialists tend to be in the TA. So a lot of TA officers and rankers have found themselves on the front line in any case, sometimes in the first deployment.
And then once they join the TA...
Veteran ex-regular Graham Smith is this region's welfare officer for the TA.
The expectation is that they will have to go on an operational tour, so they don't really have a choice. That is the expectation, and that's what they're signing up for. So once the training has been completed, the expectation is that we will turn around and say, there's an operational tour coming up, and we are expecting you to serve on that operational tour, and here is how we're going to do it through that process of mobilisation.
But not everyone gets through unscathed, as I'm about to find out.
The commitment far exceeds what we pay them.
Graham Smith is taking me to meet the wife of a TA soldier who was recently sent to Afghanistan and who then called her from the front with a message she'll never forget.
Well, I've been shot. Just like that. So obviously I just couldn't believe what I'd heard.
What went through your mind when he said, I've been shot?
It was just a complete blank. I didn't know. I couldn't speak. I didn't know how I felt really at first. And then he started to explain that he was shot in the leg and he was going to be absolutely fine. And I think after a couple of seconds, it started to sink in and I got obviously really, really upset. But I, again, didn't want to show him on the phone that I was really upset.
You know, once you're committed to soldiering, you become incredibly selfish.
Denny's partner has now rejoined the TA, but the shock of his injury and the fact that he's got a new baby girl made him wary of another overseas mission.
He said, right, that's it. You know, I've had a shock. You know, I wasn't expecting that. And I don't know if every soldier's got that in their head, but I don't think he ever once thought anything like that was going to happen. And I think when it did and he got home, he thought, right, that's it, I can't do that again. I can't risk, you know, everything to go and do that again.
It's a freezing dawn, and Z Company is on the streets for a gruelling two-day march. A Northumberland piper tries to lift the spirits, but it's little defence against the chill northeast winds.
How many miles have we done so far?
20.
5 hours.
Which is 4 miles an hour.
Yeah, so it's... Been and that's, inclu- that's where it's faster because we've had loads of breaks in it.
Exercises like this are a way for officers like Bosnia veteran John Hunter to assess these men to see if they're fit for the battlefield.
You know, if we knew there was an individual who was wanting to deploy but really we knew hand on heart wasn't quite fit enough, we'd have that discussion with them and, you know, we'd advise them not to go ahead and to do a bit more fizz first before they went down. Because if they become a casualty due to poor fitness, then it's those that are left around who have to deal with that casualty. So it does have a serious impact on what happens out there.
With their involvement in Iraq, Afghanistan and now Libya, Britain's armed forces have already been at war longer than during World War II, increasing pressure on the TA to deliver men.
It's almost a certainty now, you know, that everyone will deploy at some time. And probably, you know, a couple of times within a 3 to 5 year time span.
I've been the TA for 26 years now. Set on a lot of courses, you know, the army's invested in me, and I think, you know, it's only fair they get a return on their investment, and it's something I think every soldier wants to do to deploy on ops for real. My children are used to it; they're used to me being away. And as for my ex-wife, she's probably not bothered either way.
So have you had any major issues with your feet? The march is over for the day, and it's time to inspect damaged feet.
Is it, like, incredibly painful, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Yeah, if that ruptures,
then what you've got is a huge chance for infection.
Wait, it's just quality, this is well skills, like discipline, like commitment to what I put into things now. Like, I would just, before I joined with TA, like, I would give up on things if they weren't going my way. I wouldn't be too happy about it, but no, I'll keep on trying and like do me 100% best.
These two TA soldiers, Fusiliers Damien Rowell and Ross Davison, are working one of their last shifts at a paintball company. But soon they'll be firing real bullets in Afghanistan.
We're both going as frontline soldiers. We've been taught we're riflemen for the squads and that.
So you're going to be on the front line?
Yeah.
And riflemen means you're really going to be out there among it?
I'm a bit nervous, but and I'm happy I'm going, but I think that when it gets closer to the actual time of deploying out there, and then I will feel it, I will. It is shocking that it has come quick, but it's something I want to do in life.
How do you feel about this now?
A bit nervous, but it's something I've always wanted to do, fight for my country. It's going to need a lot more, we'll not be able, a lot more fighting out there. With some other lord and dead, there'll be someone new appointed with the Taliban leader, and he'll just want to make his name, so it's going to get worse.
48-year-old veteran Corporal Moore is also deploying.
You've probably done your thing. I mean, why don't you do it? Somebody's got to look after the youngins. Is that easy?
Well, yeah. I mean, it's the job I do. I've trained for it. It's pointless training for it if you're not going to use it.
It's the summer season, the fighting season. How do you feel about going out there at the moment?
It's like everything else. There's danger in everything you do. In civilian life, I drive a truck, and how many people get killed on the roads? There's risk involved in everything you do.
Are your friends coming for your birthday?
Darren's deployment to Afghanistan is nearly here. Weeks of intensive training with regular soldiers will start within days.
I think I'd rather him do a job that he's happy and good at doing than being stuck in a dead-end job, really.
His partner was also in the TA. It's where they met, and she understands his desire to go. But leaving her and their baby girl, Holly, isn't easy.
My will's sorted. Life insurance. It's all done. The only thing we don't know.
But does it concern you?
It's a day-to-day job. You go out there, get hit by a bus. Just as more, you don't think of that, it's a job. I've treated it as a job and that's it. Not as if it happens, it happens, it doesn't. So no, we're getting upset about it, really, is it? Get hit by a bus, really. So there was someone killed there on Monday, a roadside bomb. It's the biggest threat out there now, but technology's moving forward. We should be okay. Got to think positive all the time.
Shot.
Like a year after.
A year after.
Yeah,
right.
That's the end of the day.
Danny, whose partner was shot in Afghanistan, now knows that he's changed his mind and is going back to the war after all.
It's really hit home that he's gone and... Stage, he's gone, and I know there's nothing I can say that will change that. And it's not the fact that, you know, he doesn't care, he does care deeply, but he knows this is what he has to do, and I wouldn't stop him from doing it because I know that he wouldn't be happy.
Soon after, the Fusiliers are back on the streets, blisters and all, marching ever closer to the day they leave for the front lines. Sergeant Redpath knows there's a chance not all of these men might make it home again. And it gives him pause to think of the two daughters he'll be leaving behind.
They hope that, you know, that I'll come back okay, then I'll be safe. They haven't voiced any worries to me, but probably in their minds they probably just think, oh, it won't happen to Dad. Dad will be stacking blankets or doing something equally as exciting as that. I think at the same time, every time I say goodbye to my kids, whether it's just me going back to my house or whether I'm going to deploy, I always tell them I love them in case it's the last time I see them.
Nervous times there, and how ironic that just as those guys prepare to go to Afghanistan, the British government is thinking about withdrawing troops.